can we get this E350 van running? Everyone at the front desk says it needs a fuel pump. Something doesn't seem right. Let's take a look. Got this 06 E350. No start, right on the road. Of course, everyone's driven it and moved it around. It's been here since Monday, and I was off yesterday, so they saved it for me to reward me for taking a day off. He said, oh, this one's next. They keep calling. Well, because it's been here for 2 days waiting for me to come back. And it starts. Service RSC now. Uh-oh, stalled. Put the windows down because it's hot. All right, let me see if I can nurse this thing into the shop without the camera on. Gas gauge reads a third of a tank. All right, let's try to trust the old rubber mallet. See if that does something. Sometimes you gotta have someone cranking it while you smack the tank to get it to motor to fire up. Uh-oh. All right. That trick is not gonna work on this one. I have to get someone to push me in. Nope. No such luck. All right. Uh-oh. No start, no communication with the PCM. And the ABS is mad about it. Let's go see what other modules I could talk to. See if they're mad. Let's talk to the cluster. Read fault codes. Key on engine off. U1900 CAN bus error, ignition key and circuit error, U19 CAN bus reception error. Interesting. So all the modules are mad. I see some custom wiring. You bypass the relay. More custom wiring. Alright. Let's go pull some wiring diagrams and fuse diagrams. That don't look good. Uh-oh. Oh, someone's been in here. He said it died while he was driving. But someone's obviously been playing with it. I'm going to go get a wiring diagram and see what's up with the PCM powers and grounds. Well, on the old Ford van. Well, now it just shut off, see? There was a 5-amp fuse in the fuse box. It only read 5.8 volts. I put a 20-amp fuse in and started up. Now it just shut off. So now we'll see what kind of voltage is on that fuse. What? 6 volts. From the other side. Very strange. Let's see if that fuse is blown again. There might be a short on that circuit. I'm gonna have to put my short finder in this thing. Or it is a connection issue. Fuse isn't blown. All right. We're gonna have to dig a little deeper. Maybe something going on with this fuse panel. We'll come back. All right, I think what's happening on this Ford is the relay has a bad contact. Because this is the fuse that's dropping voltage, and the voltage, all the other fuses going in are good. So I'm gonna find the PCM power relay, which according to this is the second relay right over here. Looks like someone may have been in here playing with it. It's a little bit hot. See if I can find me a test relay in the old toolbox. Looks fairly new. You know what I'll do too? I'll show you what the voltage is with this relay in here. Oh, I just heard a click. All kinds of stuff gets happy. Let's see what the voltage is on the output fuse to the PCM. Now it's showing good. So now it's going to run. So disturbing that relay probably fixed it. Let's try jiggling it. Bet you it'll start now. Oh. Running like a champ. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to let this thing run, and when it shuts off again, I'll make sure my voltage dropped again. I'll put that other relay in, and then I'm going to have to let it run a while and see if I can get it to act up again. If it doesn't act up after that, I know it's the relay. I'll have to order me a new one. That one's out of the toolbox just for testing. All right, I got this monstrosity to act up. Lost voltage on that fuse. Put my test relay in. Now I got it running. It's been about 10 minutes. I'm going to go in here and look at the fuel pressure while we have it, just for kicks. Want to make sure she's good to go. Might as well, since everyone up front told me it probably had a bad fuel pump. These guys are good up front. I'm just glad that on this one, they didn't already order the fuel pump and pre-sell it. Luckily, they at least let me look at it first. Fuel pump percentage, fuel rail pressure. Look at there. You got about 46 PSI, 41 PSI, and the fuel pump percentage is only 23%. So if the fuel pump's not running at 60, 70% or over, then you know the fuel pump's good. This thing's got the fuel pump running at under 25%. Fuel pump's good. Take a screen capture so they can't be called a liar. Yep, this one's gonna be fixed. Boom. All right, thanks for watching. I hope you got something out of that no start E350 diag. See you in the next video.